I'm here at EsNews Boxing talking to boxing trainer Brandon Krause. Brandon, in just a few days, you have Lucas Mattysse, the pride of Argentina.
Uh-huh.
Knockout artist against John Molina Jr. right here from Southern California. Also,
yeah.
A very hard-hitting fight. I just moved because the light.
I can watch my fighters too.
John Molina Jr., very hard-hitting fighter, very talented. Fireworks.
Huh? You good?
Yeah. Seems, you know, on paper, like an awful lot for John Molina to bite off in his first fight at 140.
The second fight, he had 140 a while ago.
Oh, okay.
But first big fight,
significant fight at Junior Walter. But a full disclosure, you know, Team Outlaws has a relationship with John Molina, and I'm rooting for John Molina. I'm a fan of his, and so I should just put that out there. But you know, with no bias, I think that it's fair to say that if anybody in the sport of boxing is a warrior, John Molina is. He's a legitimate puncher, and he's a puncher that definitely believes in his power up until the final bell, and that power has bailed him out of sticky situations before. Everybody in the boxing circle loves this Argentine. They think very highly of him and his punching power, and I think he has also legit 140-pound power. But there's some intangibles here, you know, that go beyond just looking at this fight on paper and just evaluating maybe Molina's plodding style versus maybe some of the more refined things you've seen Mattysse do. And yeah, look, that is true. And I think Molina and Joe Goosen understand well what John is going to bring into that fight. And with that being said, that warrior mentality may be enough. You know, I've seen John Molina losing round after round after round and still have the desire to win and pull fights out in his favor. And I've seen Mattysse in similar situation with Danny Garcia. And the second his eyes started shutting, it seemed like he wasn't as intense anymore. That was a very difficult fight against, you know, a world-class king 140-pounders, that's for sure. But you know this is going to be fireworks. It's at StubHub Center, no less. So that just guarantees that it's going to be a barn burner. And
no bad seat in the house.
No bad seat in the house. And there's just some energy about that Carson venue that, you know, some of the best fights we've seen in the recent past have happened there. And I'm going to be live. And I know I'm going to see a good fight.
There you have it. Brandon Krause, stay tuned. EsNews Boxing.com. And Melissa, back reporting. So I'm going to ask you about the past.